Dante's Weaponry in Devil May Cry 5. So, again for the team, so could you tell us a little bit about Dante in Devil May Cry 5?
はい、今回ダンテ、たくさんの武器を用意してます。で、今日はまだこの誰にも発表してない武器をいくつか皆さんに紹介したいと思います。
Yes, all right. So for Dante here, he's got a lot of different weapons at his disposal, and we're about to show you guys some weapons you've seen before, but also some weapons that we're showing for the first time here. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Let's start with the OG, shall we?
Let's do it.
Start with Ebony and Ivory.
Ebony and Ivory.
ご存知の通りエボリアンダイボリなんですけど、これゲームの中のギャラリーモードでこうやって動かして見ることができます。
Yeah. Well, as you guys can see, it's the ebony and ivory that everybody loves and knows and loves. And in that video there, you can see that we have gallery mode where you'll be able to take a look at the weapons, all the weapons, and turn them around like that and take a view of them.
今回はちゃんとね、エボニーとアイボリーで特殊性とパワーっていうふうに違う特性を持たせてますんで。
And interestingly, so the idea behind Ebony and Ivory was that they were gonna kind of have different characteristics. One was gonna be more powerful, and one was gonna have a higher firing rate. And so we've actually implemented that in this one.
Gunslinger で。
So try them out with Gunslinger and see what happens. Yeah.
Nice. Let's move on to our next weapon.We got the Coyote Egg.
Coyote は映像見て。
Like, is there anything you don't want to say about it? I want people to look at the video. All right, let's check it out. He's having his way with that guy.
今回ね、仕掛けコードの途中とかいろんなコードの途中で自然に銃が撃てるように、頑張って作ってます。
We've done a lot to really pay attention to the animations and stuff, so that as you can see, like, he's gonna animate with it differently for each different, for when he's using it during each different animation that he's triggered it during. So, check it out.
Cool, cool. Now we have another weapon. I think this one's got a new spin on it.We have it.
It's not the Kalina Anno, it's the Kalina Ann 2. Woo! Two.
Hey, let's look at it.
はい、カリナーン2は、カリナーン、もちろんオリジナルカリナーンっていうのはレディのカリナーンなんですけど、レディの依頼でリコが作ったカリーナ・アンのコピーですね。驚くべき性能というか驚くべき機能が隠されているんですけど、今はまだ内緒です。
So the idea, the reason that it's Kalina Ann 2 and not Kalina Ann is because, well, as you guys know, the Kalina Ann is ladies, that's hers. So, she asked Nico to make Dante one, and Nico tried her best to.Create a Kalina Ann that was going to match that of Lady. So we have a lot of new stuff with Kalina Ann 2 to show, but we'll save that for later.
All right, let's get ready for some sword play. We have Rebellion.
Hi, おなじみリベリオンなんですけど、フォーマルとはちょっとだけデザインが変わっていますね。
It's the rebellion that everybody knows and loves, but if you pay attention, you'll be able to see that we've updated the design a little bit since DMC4. Oh, that feels good. That feels good.
Ah, feels good every time.
Doesn't it though? Oh, I love that.
So good.
I love that in trailers, man.
All right, now let's look at our next weapon for Duncan. Some of you guys will definitely recognize this. Spider! It's a weapon with some real teeth.
スパーダーなんですけど、ね、中にフォースイッチが入ってるんですけどね、今回ちょっとフォースイッチがずっとプレイステーション2のままですごくポリゴンが荒かったんで、今回デザインから全部やり直してすごくかっこいい形になってます。
So the idea is that this was derived from the Force Edge, right? The Force Edge is actually technically part of this. And up through DMC4, we had always used the same PS2 model for the Force Edge in that. And you know, it's PS2, so the polygon count is really low. So it was starting to look pretty bad. And so we basically remade this weapon with the idea that, all right, we're going to make the Force Edge finally look, you know, better than it, and up to date with today's hardware.
Let's see it in action.
まあ、ちゃんとあの3形態に変形してるので、
So you can see it's still transformed.
Alright, let's move on to our next weapon. You got...
Oh!
Yeah! I knew you guys would be excited to see this. A little updated.
Cerberus is back.
ケルベロス、今回驚くべき進化を遂げていますので、そうですね、ビデオを見てもらった方が楽しいんじゃないかなと思います。
Well, how about...Before we say anything, let's take a look at the video. Let's take a look at the next. Let's take a look at the next video to see just what's going on with Kerberos this time.
Yeah, we gotta check this out.
It transforms?
こう、氷の、まあ、三着、氷の三着と炎の棒ですね、棒と、雷の三節点と3つの形態に変化します。
So as you can see, it transforms into three different forms here. We have the ice nunchucks, and then we have the fire bow that it transforms into, and thenThe lightning chain staff nunchuck thing. I'm sure there's a proper term for that. I just don't know what it is.
Cerberus.
There you go.
That's the proper term.
Cerberus. All right, Cerberus. All right, that works too.
All right.
There you go.
Oh, that looks so good.
That's something new. That's something new, I think.
Yeah, you can totally wreck up someone's day with that.All right, so Matt, do you want to start talking about Dante's sick ride?
Let's do it, baby.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Let's do it. Yeah. Let's talk about Cavaliere.
はい、おなじみキャバリエレですね。
I think you guys have seen this one. Start show this one. There we go, the way it transforms into two here.
こうやって、ね、止まった絵でしっかりと2つに分かれたところ見れるのは、初めてじゃないかなと思います、
That's cool. I mean, you know, it's the first time. This is actually the first time where we've really shown off how they look when they're separated like that. So that's pretty cool. And as you can see, it's essentially dual-wielding chainsaws, more or less.
That you can also ride, right?
That you can also ride, exactly.
Yeah. You know, it does double duty, if you will. All right, let's see it in action.
And now.
Woo!
our buddy Yoshida-san. Our buddy Yoshida-san showing off there, showing off his mad cavalier skills, being cavalier about it in the process.
バイクに乗ってる時のアクションはソードマスターのアクションね。
And actually, so if when you're gonna want to ride a bike like that, you'll be doing that when you're in Sword Master. So keep that in mind. That's how you're gonna be able to pull off the sick riding moves.
And now.
Sweet.
Yeah. All right. Now I'm gonna look at something completely different. We got the bar.
This is another one where this is like the first time we're actually showing off like what they look like separate, you know, from when Dante's wearing them. The Balrog.
ちゃんとね、バルログのね、顔になってるんですよね。あのちょうど腕と足の真ん中とかあれバルログっていう、バルログっていうまだ公開してないモンスターの顔になってますね。
And you can actually, the way they're set up there, you can see when they kind of sit together like that, they kind of form the face of the Balrog. AndNobody's ever seen a Balrog in Devil May Cry before, but this is what it would look like.
Oh, cool. All right, let's see it in action.
All right. So here Dante's using blow mode. I love that. And there's two modes, right? So, okay, and here he's switching to kick mode, which is kind of more of this capoeira style, whereas blow mode is more of a boxing style.
あのバルログは普段肩についてるパーツがあのブローモードの時はちゃんと手の先に移動してるんですよね。でキックモードの時はちゃんと足の方に移動しています。
If you actually pay attention, you'll see that he's got these shoulder pads that when he's in blow mode, they're gonna basically become these kind of brass knuckles on the gauntlets on his arms, and then when he goes into kick mode, they actually transfer down to his legs.
あのね、今炎に燃え上がってるのはあのイグニッションっていうあの、まあ、技でして、ブローモードの場合は空振りでもいいんで10回殴るとあのイグニッションモードになるし、キックモードの時はあのなんかカポエラこういうやるとあのどんどんヒートアップしてイグニッションになります。
And maybe you're wondering like, okay, what's with the fire? Like, how's that work? Well, you'll see that as he's punching in blow mode there, whether you've connected with the punch or not, that builds up the fire. There's a move called ignition. And then when you're in kick mode, you can do a little, I'm not going to do the dance thing, but the little capoeira dance, when you do that, that's how that powers up ignition in that mode.
Oh, it looks so cool. It looks kind of like he's like almost like doing like a shoryuken there.
Yeah, man.
リアルインパクトはあの、まあ、ブローモードであの一番ヒートアップした状態で、ライジングドラゴンするとあのリアルインパクトになります。
So that's a move called real impact. That's real impact. And what will happen is when you've built up ignition like that all the way to its max in blow mode, that's when you can do that move, the one that looks like a Shinsoryuga there. Real impact.
Oh my god, it's so cool. All right, so this next one I think is totally new for the audience as well, and I think has actually got one of the coolest mechanics in the game. Check out the Faust High.
これも今回初公開の武器、ファーストハット。
This is, as you guys have indicated, this is a brand, this is an exclusive look at a weapon we've never revealed before.
あの、4にできたファウストっていう敵の、敵が、武器になった武器ですね。
武器になった
武器。マグになったやつですね。はい、
so, as you can see here, this is a hat.
It's quite a hat.
It's quite a hat, isn't it? And so you can see the eyes there. So there's an enemy in DMC 4 called the Faust. And so this is weaponized form of the Faust, essentially. So as you can see, he's got the eyes here.
This is a ちょっと面白い武器なんで動いたやつ見てもらいましょうかね。
And it's, this is an interesting weapon. Let's see what it looks like when you're
fighting
with it.
All right, let's see. It is very interesting.
この武器はね、ファウストハットのハットとマフラーね、マフラー、ファウストのマントの形をしたマフラーで一つの組になってるんですね。
You can see, there's kind of two parts of the weapon there. There's the hat, and then... Boom! And then...He's got the scarf that is it's kind of based on the cape that Faust had in DMC4.
で、そう絵を見て何やと思ったかもしれないですけど、これはこの武器はね、自分が貯めたレッドをぶつけるっていう武器なんですね。で、言いますよ。で、レッドオーブをぶつけると持ってるレッドオーブ減る代わりにすんげえ強いんですよ。で、さっきの隕石降ってきたやつも貯めれば貯めるほどでっかい隕石が降ってくるし、めちゃめちゃお金減るんですけど、もう一つ、あ、まずそれだけ言おうか。もう一つ言うと、このね、ハットを投げて敵にかぶらせた状態で攻撃するとすっげえいっぱいレッドオーブ出てくるんですよ。だからレッドオーブをたくさん使うんだけども、レッドオーブをたくさん儲けるための武器でもあります。
So as you can see, he's got all these crazy moves with this, and the way it works is there's supposed to be a risk and reward with it. So like this move, for instance, here, you use your red orbs to use this, and you can also, what'll happen is you can use your red orbs andLike, for instance, that meteorite move, that's going to use a ton of red orbs. But with this weapon, the other thing you can do is, if you attack with that throw, the way he throws the hat, if you beat an enemy with that, you get a ton of red orbs back. So the idea is, you want to use this, and you want to beat the enemies with that move, because that way you're going to get a ton of red orbs back when you beat the enemy.
その代わりね、ハットを投げて敵についてるときに自分攻撃食らったら、自分からもいっぱいレッドオブする。
And the idea with that hat throw move is you're marking the enemy. So you can attack the enemy with red orbs, but because it's this risk and reward thing, what will happen is if you attack with the hat and you get attacked by that enemy, you're going to lose red orbs as you get attacked.
で、あとね、マフラーの長さが自分が持ってる残りレッドオーブの数を表しています。
And the length of the scarf is dependent on how many red orbs you have in your inventory. So the more red orbs you have, the longer it's going to be.
そう、これがね、貯めれば貯めるほどでっかいレッドオーブの隕石が落ちてくるんですね。
And yeah, with that meteorite move, then the more red orbs you move, the more powerful, the bigger that's going to be as well.
超かっこいいと思う。
Yeah, like it was the story of Faust itself, risk and reward.
Exactly.
Like a deal with the devil, if you will.